This is the class test 1 for 8th standard. This class test includes chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3. In this video, we are going to understand how to solve the question paper properly. So this question paper consists of various questions and sub-questions. So we are going to look at them one by one and understand how to write it in the answer sheet. So question number one, as you can see, question number 1A is fill in the blank. So question number 1A is fill in the blank. So we have to write down question number 1A, fill in the blanks. Now the very first fill in the blank is the air pressure in our body is equal to dash pressure. Answer is atmospheric. So we have to write down the air pressure in our body is equal to atmospheric pressure, underline atmospheric, and move ahead to the next question. So for fill in the blanks, you have to write the complete statement, write down the answer, underline the answer, and only then you get the required marks. So for question number 1A, fill in the blanks, we have to write the complete statement, we have to write the question number, underline the answer, and then move ahead to the next question. For example, for sub-question number 2 in fill in the blanks, bacteria cell reproduces by dash, simple binary fission. So you have to write down 2, bacteria cell reproduces by simple binary fission, underline simple binary fission, and this fill in the blank gives you 1 mark each. So we have to write the statement, underline the answer, and move ahead to the next question. So for fill in the blanks, you have to write the main question meaning question number 1A, fill in the blanks, write all the sub questions, write the number of them properly. So this is how fill in the blanks needs to be written. Let us move ahead to question number 1B, odd one out. Question number 1B, odd one out, and justify your answer. In this question also, you have to write the question number, that is question number 1B, write down the main question, which is odd one out, and justify your answer. Now the sub question here is number 1, there are given 4 options. Out of these 4 options, one option is not suitable here. So you have to pick out the option which is not suitable here, write it down in the answer. Also, you have to write down the reason why that option is not suitable here. For example, the very first question here is malaria, hepatitis, elephantiasis, dengue. So here given are 4 diseases. Out of these 4 diseases, one disease is not suitable here. So the disease which is not suitable here is hepatitis. So you have to write down answer hepatitis. Now, also, as I told you have to write down the reason. So the reason here is all other diseases are caused by mosquito, hepatitis is caused by contaminated water. So you have to write down the main question, you have to write the sub question, that is 1, all the 4 options, write down the answer, write down the reason for why the option is not suitable. For example, for the second question, the second sub question, In second sub-question, there are 4 options given. Euglena, Volvox, amoeba, Corella. Now, out of these options, amoeba is not suitable here. So, we have to write down answer amoeba. Reason for it, all others are algae. So, this is how question number 1B needs to be written. You have to write the main question. You have to write the sub-question number, sub-question, answer, and reason. Let us move ahead to question number 1C. Question number 1C is, as you can see, is a match the column. So you have to write the question number 1C, match the column, that is the main question. Now, in this question, there are 2 columns. So you have to draw these 2 columns. You have to name all the options here. For example, in column 1, the options are named in numerical order. So you have to write down as written in the question paper. For example, 1 typhi, 2 virus, 3 amoeba, 4 dysentery. Similarly, in the second column, you have to write down as given in the question paper in alphabetical order. Okay, now on writing this match the column, so this is the question of match the column. Now you have to write down the answer. To write the answer, let us see the first example. The very first option here is typhoid. Now typhoid goes with C. salmonella typhi. So typhoid here goes with C. salmonella typhi. So in answer you have to write 1 C, which means option 1 goes with option C in the second column. Similarly for virus, the second option here is virus. So in answer you have to write 2. Now the second option virus goes with the option D, bacteriophage. So you have to write down 2D. This is how you have to solve the third match the column, also the fourth. So you have to write the numbers of both the columns. Yes. This is how match the columns needs to be solved. Let us move ahead to question number 1D. The question number 1D, as you can see, is name the following. Now in question number 1D, you have to write the main question. Question number 1D, name the following. Also the sub question number is the first sub question here is the bacteria that causes tuberculosis. So you have to write the main question, write the sub question number 1, the sub question, the bacteria that causes tuberculosis. Answer is Mycobacterium tuberculae. Mycobacterium tuberculae. So you have to write the sub question, you have to write the answer. Now here you have to write the answer in 1 or 2 words. You don't have to write the answer in a complete statement. For example, as you can see, for sub question 2, the question is the unit of density. So we have to write the sub question number 2, write the question, the unit of density. In answer, write the unit of density, that is g by cm cube, that is gram per centimeter cube. So you have to just write the answer in 1 or 2 words only. For example, also for sub question number 3, the full form of RNA and DNA, you have to write the question, you have to write the sub question, you have to then write the answer. Answer here is DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid, RNA is ribonucleic acid. So you have to just write the full form RNA and DNA. Similarly, the fourth question of the name the following needs to be solved. Now let us move ahead to question number 1E. Question number 1E is true or false. Before going into question number 1E, question number 1D, each question of question number 1D carries 1 mark. So if you solve all the options correct, all the questions correctly, all the sub questions correctly of the name the following, you get 4 marks for this particular question. This is how name the following needs to be solved. You have to write the main question, you have to write the sub question, most importantly question number and answer in 1 or 2 words only. Let us move ahead to question number 1E, that is true or false. Here also, as I told you, have to write the question number, question number 1E, write the main question, that is true or false. Here also you have to write the sub question, that is 1. What is the sub question here? Lactobacilli are harmful bacteria. Lactobacilli are harmful bacteria. The option, right, answer is false. So you have to write answer false. Similarly for the second sub question, that is ELISA is a test for HIV. We have to write the sub question number, sub question, and the answer for it is true. So write answer true. So this is how true or false needs to be written. Write the question number, write the main question, write the sub question, write the sub question number, write the answer. So this is question number 1E, true or false. Similarly for the third true or false, also you have to solve in the similar manner. You have to write the sub question number that is given here, 3. Euglena is a protozoa. You have to write the question, then you have to write the answer true, as you can see on the screen. Similarly for fourth, that is SI unit of force is joule. So you have written the sub question number, you have written the sub question and answer false. So this is how true or false needs to be written. Let's move ahead to question number 1F. Question number 1F is answer in one sentence. Now, from here onwards, question number 1F, answer in one sentence. From here onwards, we don't have to write the sub-questions. We have to just write the sub-question numbers. Let us see how. So, we have to write the main question, question number 1F, answer in one sentence. We have to write the question number, that is question number 1F, write the main question, that is answer in one sentence. Then, for the very first question, answer in one sentence is, what is biological classification? As you can see here, we have not written the question. We have directly written the answer. So here you have to write the sub question number, that is 1. You don't have to write the question, you have to write the answer for sub question number 1, that is biological classification. So the answer is, the process of dividing living organisms into groups and subgroups is called biological classification. So the answer is written in one complete sentence. So here the answer should always be written in one complete sentence. We don't have to write the sub question, we have to write the sub question number, and the questions answers should be written in one complete sentence, not more than one sentence, because the question asked is answer in one sentence. Similarly, for question number 1F2, that is answer in one sentence 2, as you can see the sub question 2 here, the question asked is what is disease. So we have to write the sub question number, that is 2, write the answer for sub question number 2, move ahead to sub question number 3. As you can see, you have to write answer 3, write the answer, move ahead to sub question number 4. So this is how answer in one sentence needs to be written. There are four sub questions in answer in one sentence. Each sub question carries 1 mark. So on solving the sub questions correctly, you get 4 marks here. Let us move ahead to question number 2, that is write notes on. As I told you earlier, in this questions we don't have to write the sub questions, we have to just write the sub question numbers. So question number 2 is write notes on, write the question number, that is question number 2, write the main question, write notes on, then write the answer for sub question number 1. We don't have to write the sub question. For example, here the sub question is write the merits of Whittaker's method of classification. But as you can see on the screen, we haven't written the question. We are directly writing the answer for the sub questions, right? So we have directly written answer number 1. Whittaker's method of classification has the following merits. Yes. A. Unicellular and multicellular organisms are categorized separately. B. Autotrophic and heterotrophic modes of nutrition are placed in distinct groups. C. Fungi is a separate kingdom because of its mode of nutrition. D. It is more naturally segregated than classified under 2 kingdoms. E. Prokaryotes are unicellular organisms which are placed in kingdom Monera. So, here the answers, it is advisable to write the answers in points. It is good if you write the answer in points. So here I have written in A, B, C, D. You can write down the points as 1, Roman number 1, 2, 3, 4, or numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's always advisable to write the answer in points. This is write notes on question number 2. Here we don't have to write the sub question. We have to write the sub question number and write the answer. Similarly, for sub question number 2, that is write the prevention of cancer, we have directly written answer number 2, we have written the answer. So this is how write notes on should be written. You have to write the question number, you have to write the main question, you have to write the sub question number and answer. Let us move ahead to question number 3, that is answer in brief. As similar to question number 2, we have to write the main question, question number 3, answer in brief. Also here we have not written the sub question number, so we don't have to write the sub question number here. We have to directly write the sub question number and write the answer for sub question number 1 and also sub question number
2. Now, here the sub-question number 2 is a differentiation. Now, as you can see, for differentiation, we have to make 2 columns. Okay, we have to make 2 columns, as you can see on the screen. Write down the diseases or forces or objects which needs to be differentiated on two different columns. So we have to draw a table with 2 different columns. Write down the points of difference between them. For example, here it is infectious and non-infectious disease. So the very first difference is it can be transmitted from one individual to another. It cannot, and for non-infectious disease it is it cannot be transmitted from one individual to another. In this way, you have to write down in points. You have to write down the difference in points. So here we have points of differences. So in differentiation, you have to write the answer in points. You have to write the points of differences between the two diseases. This question carries 2 marks. Question number 3 carries 4 marks together. Sub question number 1 carries 2 marks. Sub question number 2 carries 2 marks. So each point of this differentiation carries half mark. So we have to write all the 4 points of the differences between them and then move ahead to the next question. So question number 4 is give reason. Give reason is as same as question number 3 and 2. You have to write the main question, that is question number 4, give reason. Write the sub question number, that is 1, and write the answer. So in give reason also, we have to write the main question, you have to write the question number and also the sub question number and write the answer, as you can see. So here we have 2 questions, 2 sub questions, 1 and 2, that is answer number 1 and answer number 2. Give reasons carry 4 marks. So if you solve both the questions correctly, both the sub questions correctly, you get 4 marks here. Let us move ahead to question number 5. Now question number 5, as you can see, is solve the given numerical. So the question number 5 is solve the given numerical. Here also you have to write this main question, write the main question number also. Yes, you have to write the main question number, that is question number 5. Write the main question, solve the given numericals. You don't have to write the question sub question here. Here also you have to just write the sub question number, that is 1. Solve the numericals. Now in numerical you have to write what is given in the question. For example, in this numerical, it is given volume of the box. So we have to write given volume of the box is 350 centimeter cube. Mass of the box 500 grams. So you have to write what is given, solve the given numerical. As you can see at the end, we have found out the mass of liquid. So you have to write the closing answer, the mass of the given liquid is 350 grams. If you don't write the answer at the end, or you fail to write the answer, the mass of the liquid is 350 grams, a closing answer, you lose half mark here. So after solving the complete numerical at the end, as you can see, you have to write answer, the mass of the given liquid is 350 grams. Similarly, for question number 6, also you have to write the question number. Question number 6, write, draw the neat labeled diagram. So you have to write the main question number, you have to write the question number and question, main question. Now, here there are given, you have to draw the diagram of 2 organisms here, bacteriophage and paramecium. Now, draw neat labeled diagram. Draw neat means you have to draw a very neat looking diagram. Labeled meaning you have to label all, you have to label all the parts of the organisms as given in the textbook. For example, bacteriophage, you have to draw the structure of bacteriophage, name all the parts with pencil. So diagrams should always be written in pencil. Draw the diagram, write the labels in pencil, and then you get 2 marks each for each diagram. So for the very first diagram, that is question number 6, 1, bacteriophage is of 2 marks. Question number 6, 2, paramecium is of
2 marks. So you have to draw the diagram with pencil. You have to write all the labels in pencil correctly, and then you get 4 marks here. So this is how the question paper needs to be solved. You have to write the question number, main question number. You have to write the main question. Yes, so question number is very important here. You have to always write the question number correctly. Because if you fail to write the question number correctly, it can be problematic. You may lose marks. So always check at the end of the examination that whether you have written the question numbers correctly. That's thank you.